I've got.
Recording has been started if we'd like to get going with that.
Who wants to give a recap?
Not too much happened. We had the fight with the mummies. A couple of people got mummy rot. The snake did not get mummy rot. We poke around a little bit, see a pool in the distance, go, let's check it out. Some of us considering that there was probably a boss fight there, others just being like, let's do this. There is a boss fight with, I do not remember her name, but I remember her epithet.
Ailild.
Ailild, the first undead, which has fascinating world-building implications, by the way, and I cannot wait to delve into it some more. But we ended the session with her emerging and the boss fight beginning.
Mm-hmm. All right. You should be on the map now.
Where should we be on the map?
Towards this door.
Okay.
Joe, I'm liking your plan now more than ever.
Yeah, realizing how close we are to it, it's like, yeah, let's look and see how this goes.
Where are the homies? Hi, the homies.
Yeah, realizing how close to it we are on this map, it's like, yeah, fuck it, let's go.
Alright, if everyone could roll initiative, please.
Yeehaw! God damn it, I keep rolling low!
Cool!
Oh, Cypress, you're supposed to be the first liner, damn it. let's see. This is what happens when I can't be a half-shifted person. let's see, I'm gonna roll to be on the initiative, just give me 1 second.
And, 16.
Good god, I should just start using the dice roller for this, good lord.
Wait, what is an 8.
It just-
Oh, 25, why? That's not great.
I wasted a natural 20 with the stupid dice roller.
I will roll to get Renzen and Horror on the initiative.
My opal dice are betraying me today already.
They're pretty, so they know they don't have to.
But they always roll so well, but they're like, not for Cypress. Oh well.
Okay.
This just means he has more time to think about things.
That was too much for
Aleth. Also needs to roll.
Roll lower than me.
She did.
Yes!
Manifest!
They did, yeah. Oh my god.
Or they did, yeah.
By one.
Ailild is going to go first, however.
Oh, yeah.
As she kind of steps out of this upright sarcophagus, she again is, like, kind of covered in this burial shroud. Her long hair sort of tangled and straw-like, but cascading down her back. She's very graceful, almost, even as she steps between the unlit candles and the offerings there. And she's going to step forward. And ironically, she's gonna open her mouth and scream.
Yo.
Yo.
Mad.
Or more accurately, it is a keening wail. Half pain and half sorrow. And I need everyone to make me a will save.
Okay.
Let's
try my purple heart dice.
Done this.
Oh, that went on the floor.
Okay.
Hold
Reroll.
Since the initiative has started, everybody gets a plus two bonus from the rage for their will saves. So add two.
And this was a will save, or will or fortitude?
A will.
Okay.
Uh-oh, girl.
Oh, I rolled really well. Okay. No! Samus!
Wait!
Question, that's with Parker. The rage plus two.
Oh, no.
Question, Parker. Is this an enchantment effect?
It is not. Oh, it is a necromancy effect.
That's fine, but I needed to check for... Oh, no!
At least it wasn't a one.
The natural seven, and then if you're accepting the rage, which you can immediately reject after this, that is a... Fucking hell, I can do math. But dice is going to EBDB.
I am rolling really well on this damage.
I wish you wouldn't say that.
I immediately rolled three ones, so...
I'm glad you said that.
Karma.
You should say that, because
Today's the day of manifest.
So. This wail that she sort of emits, like, it boxes your ears and pierces your soul almost, and all of you are sort of struck with just this aching sadness that she is emitting. Like you can almost feel her own grief, and your body shakes with it. Renza and Cypress, you feel it like rack your body, but you both take inhaled breaths. You are not strangers to this type of grief, and while others here might also be familiar, you're not able to hold on to it in the same way in this moment. You're gonna feel so bad about that joke one day, Joe.
I know it's a tasteless joke. And to be fair, I was talking about us as players, not necessarily us as characters.
So, Renza and Cypress pass. Everyone else fails.
Oh.
DC was 20, motherfucker?
DC is 21.
Ouchie!
What on earth, dude?
Gotta combat the plus two that we always get.
I don't think that's combating the plus two.
This is it. When you see the rest of her build, this is it makes sense. So those of you who failed, you're gonna take 29 points of damage.
I'm down.
What kind of damage?
I'm down. Guys, I still have con damage, and my con is already bad.
Sonic damage. Why doesn't the spell list a damage type?
So you said 29?
Yeah. Those of you who succeeded, you will only take 14.
Hmm.
So Syvus is down.
Yeah.
And you said 14. Yeah, of course it's 14 because it's round down.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. Not ideal at all.
Yeah, I'm sitting at 18 hit points. We're fine.
Everybody Okay, wait. Babe, the 6 temporary hit points from the rage, did you subtract that already?
Oh, right. No, I didn't. I have 1 hit point.
I forgot about the 6 HP.
I have 1 hit point.
That's what scalds are all about, baby.
Oh my god.
A win is a win.
A win's a win, yeah, fuck. And then she's going to take the rest of her movement. She sort of starts to float up in the air, actually. As she continues to walk forward, she steps up into the air and is going to rise about 10 feet in the air, but it's going to be 5 feet that way. And that's her turn. Syvus.
No.
I. I have 1 hit point.
You sure do.
Cool. Love it. Love it here.
Huh.
Sorry, I'm looking at my spells right now.
Take your time.
I got... Am I in range for Ill Omen?
What's the range on Ill Omen?
It's 25 feet... Oh, if it's plus 5 feet every 2 levels, then right now it should be... It's 25 feet plus 5 feet every 2 levels.
Yeah, you should be fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll cast Ill Omen. I got nothing better right now.
Okay. Remind me what that does. Like, send that in the chat or something.
That I will send... the description.
Thank you. Right, yes. Yeah, yes.
Okay.
So, if I'm level 6, they gotta roll twice. I think is how that works. And then take the lowest.
Yep. Okay, the next 2 rolls she makes. Anything else?
I'll take, like, a step back against the wall.
Okay.
I don't feel super great right now.
You sure don't.
No.
Adhara.
Cool. Really feel like you should have resistance. Oh no, because it was sonic damage, right? Well, the good news is they can potentially get her into more smacker range. Because they have a 10-foot reach with their bite. So if they get here, they should just be able to grab her ankle.
Yeah.
23 to hit?
Yep.
Cool. I don't really care about the damage on this, although this is magical damage.
Mm-hmm.
What's more important is the pull. So 8 points of magical piercing damage.
Okay.
And I'm rolling against her CMD.
All right, roll for it.
26 against her CMD.
That'll beat it.
As she is pulled 5 feet closer to it, Hara. So she is still hovering 5 feet off, but that is within reach for people to go for her.
Yes.
Yep, it sure is. She kind of shrieks a little as Adhara pulls her down. And it is Renza's turn.
I think Adhara still looks slightly uncomfortably extended.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. So I could go for the plan right now. But I don't think I will. At least not for the moment. I am going to... Because I am not a melee bitch, but I do need to stay fairly close to Adhara to get a lot of my good stuff. So I'm going to scooch to there and cast... I'm going to toss... I'm going to cast Warding Weapon again.
Okay.
So that if I do get into melee, I can avoid opportunity attacks.
Alrighty. And you are outside of her reach, so you're good. Anything else?
No, I do not have anything for a swift action, I think.
Alright. Asha.
That's me. So, I can move through ally spaces.
Yes.
And she got moved down.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Grappled by snake. So I'm going to... I just really wanted this spell. I'm going to... Oh, that's hidden from others. Okay. So I'm going to be traversing this pathway.
Mm-hmm.
Which will take me through this square. And I'm casting the spell Bladed Dash, which allows me to immediately move up to 30 feet in a straight line in any direction, momentarily leaving a multi-hued cascade of images behind me, so I've got motion blur. it does not provoke attack of opportunities. I may make a single melee attack at my highest base attack bonus against any one creature I am adjacent to at any point along the 30 feet, and I gain a circumstance bonus on this roll equal to my charisma modifier.
Okay.
Incredible.
Go for it.
So, I'm going to... I did... Okay. This is where I'm ending my movement here. But I'm here when I'm making the attack, but there's no attack of opportunity, so it doesn't matter. That is a sexy number on the dice. Plus, I'm gonna be real. I'm gonna need some help with math on this one, boys. So this is... 18 plus 5 plus 6.
You're good.
29.
Spicy. I'm going to roll damage. That's so almost the best. That's 7 points of damage, which is not that much damage. I could have done more damage with other things, but this is really cool and I've been waiting to use it, so.
It is rad. You see Asha just kind of like sprint, kind of the colors of like their hair and their jacket kind of like almost melting behind them.
Shit.
And they lash out for one attack and then keep moving and skid to a stop over there towards the sarcophagus.
Dope.
The great thing about that spell is that technically that gives me 30 feet of bonus movement. I haven't used any of my actual movement. But I don't feel like using my actual movement because I feel like this is a solid strategic place for me to be. That's gonna be my except I heal 2 points from my Scaldic Vigor because I get to do that at the end of every turn that I'm raging.
Fantastic.
Get vigored, idiot.
Enable that.
Oh yeah.
Hell yeah.
Actually, PK, what color should I use for the rage?
I've said blue. Soothing, but not really invigorating.
Okay.
All right. Cypress.
Hi. Let's see. Hold on. I need to make sure. So my... Yes. So... Give me a second. I think that's only... I'm going to let's see. So am I able to get to here and then here?
Yes, you will like you will step in the pool a little bit. The pool is ground level.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Then I would like to get on the opposite side of her. Mm-hmm. And that was my full movement. Can I still take both of my attacks with my standard?
You can only take one if you had to move. If you have to move more than 5 feet.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to power attack with my sickle because that's all I can really do. Since well,
oh, what?
Yeah, no, that's not going to benefit me. I'll do my sickle. And that's power attack. Oh God. Okay, maybe that'll hit. So that's an unnatural 20. Actually, I get a bonus from
you'll hit.
Okay, cool.
Ooh.
Okay. So I need my d6 plus 9. So that would be 14 points of damage with my sickle.
Okay.
Oh, no, never mind. We're good. I forgot I also got a bonus from flanking, but it's fine.
Yeah, you're good.
Mm-hmm. And I think that's the end of my turn.
Okay. Elith is going to... start moving in this direction. But as she goes, she's going to turn and take a crossbow shot.
I think they are they them.
Oh, they them. Right, yes. I am fool. Sorry.
It's fine.
And they got a natural 20.
Yes, Elif!
Now... I don't know if they would get that precision damage, but unfortunately precision damage does not multiply on a crit.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, don't remind him of that.
I have to. No, because unfortunately this is something that might bite me in the ass later.
Well, if that is the case, then that's when you remind him. You remind him when it's relevant to your personal suffering, you know?
So they are going to hit, and they're going to, like, the bolt sort of lands, like, in between two ribs, and they do 13 points of damage. And Ayla does not look happy about this. However, that's all they can do. Aelid is going to roll a fortitude save.
I'd have to take the lower roll.
Yep.
Let's go.
And that is going to be a failure. And you see them kind of in the air. Her in the air. She turns, like, to reach down towards Cypress. And then, like, her arm sort of jerks wrong. And then she pulls it back in, and then you see her kind of double over a little bit, and she is just racked with, like, these violent shakes for a moment.
Oh, God.
And it is Sidus' turn.
I'm gonna cast Cure Serious Wounds on myself.
Hell yeah!
That's the strat right there.
Where's her own? Should've got my dice out. So sorry.
Take your time.
That's 3d8 plus my caster level.
Mm-hmm.
5, 10... That's 20 points of healing for me.
Go.
Congratulations.
I'm now at a more reasonable level. Let's go. That's my turn. I'll take like another couple steps this way.
Fair and valid.
Am I still? I'm in range for Ill Omen. I'm good. That's my turn.
All right, Adhara.
Cool. Going to attempt another bite and pull, and if I succeed on the bite and the pull, I'm going to do a tail smack.
Go for it.
Uh, 24 to hit?
Yep.
Cool. I'm on that dice, I want this dice. Yeah. 8 points of damage.
Okay.
And I'm gonna attempt the pull. 22 on her CMD.
That is going to fail.
Yeah, that's what I figured. Comparing it to Adhara's CMD, I was like, okay, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So she doesn't get moved 5 feet closer, so don't... She's 5 foot up there right next to, so would they be able to tail smack?
Yep.
Okay, they've got a 5 foot range on the tail smack, so.
Mm-hmm. Fuck Pythagoras, you can do it.
Yeah, that's a no. Because that's a 4.
Yeah, that's not gonna hit.
Because secondary attacks suck.
L.
Sorry about that.
It's okay.
Frenza.
Because here's the thing, I do want to experiment with some other little dudes, but also it's always really helpful. So I think right now, I'm just gonna do a touch attack, a ranged touch attack.
Mm-hmm.
Not that dice, this dice. Okay, that's what I was after. 22 for touch attack.
That'll hit.
Okay. T- 2 points of acid damage. I really am... One advantage Pathfinder 2e has is that spells scale a lot better. Spells actually can scale. Yeah, that's just 2 points of acid damage, and that's meeks. I don't really want to move away from my horror at the moment.
Okay. Asha.
I am going to... tell you to make... Homies, should I be funnier or more effective?
Effective, perhaps, since we're hurting a little.
Actually, no, here's the real question. Does this bitch have better will saves or fortitude saves? Vote now on your phones.
She's undead, so maybe... fortitude? I don't know.
Back will. I would suspect she's got worse will saves.
Yeah.
Worse will saves is your theory.
Yes.
So I should ask for a will save.
I think so, yeah.
That is the less funny option, but I will accept it. Parker.
Mm-hmm.
Will save.
She has disadvantage.
I'm so cool.
I don't think a 12 is gonna do it.
No, because the DC was an 18. Congratulations. You have fallen victim to the curse of executive dysfunction. You take no action until you make a successful will save.
Okay. What kind of effect is this specifically?
What is the word? It's a compulsion effect.
Okay,
mind-affecting effect. Oh, I guess she might be... I didn't think about her having a mind or not. That was a little silly of me.
I am checking.
So if I am cursing you with executive dysfunction is the less funny option.
Yeah, that is the less funny option.
What's funny option?
Oh, you'll find out.
Unfortunately, she is immune to all mind-affecting effects.
I should have thought about that. That was stupid. That's fine. That's my turn.
That's okay.
We didn't know. It's okay.
I did! I know how undead work! Sorry, that was a weird reaction to that. I'm fine, I'm good.
Honk.
Anything else you would like to do?
That is my whole turn.
Cypress.
Hi. I want to attack this thing.
Okay,
I'm
go
going
for
to do power attack twice.
Alright.
First one.
Attack a kill.
God damn it! I need to stop rolling under tens. That's a 15 to hit. I don't think that hits.
Unfortunately.
Even
no.
With the plus 2 for flanking?
Oh, 17?
You're not technically flanking because she is up in the air.
Oh.
Whatever. It's fine.
Okay.
The 15 is not gonna make it.
A 20 to hit. I mean, I technically
that'll make
have,
it though.
I technically have the plus one from the rage, but you know, I forgot. It's fine. And I'm sure the first one doesn't hit anyways.
It does not, no. The 20 will hit though.
Well, hey, at least I rolled max on my damage die. What do I get for that one? That was only my second one though, which I get less on, which fucking sucks. Oh wait, no, the thing is the same, it's just the addition. Fuck.
You're okay.
16 points of damage. God, I forget that we get an add to that.
how many again?
16, I believe.
Okay. It is Eleth's turn, and Eleth is going to take another shot. and is going to miss this time, unfortunately, but is going to slip over here behind this little cage thing and going to roll a stealth. Okay, and that is going to be... Yeah, it's going to be like an 18, she's fine. Or a 28, she's fine. They're fine. Shit. I don't know why I'm struggling with that today.
The numbers today are not working.
No, I'm talking about the pronouns. Fuck.
That too.
Aelid is going to roll another fort save. She's gonna have to roll a 1 on that, but she's also gonna roll her will save. And that's gonna be a 25. Oh wait, she doesn't have to roll the will save because she's immune. Right. She's still gonna fuck up her fort save. And so she is still kind of like hunched over on herself, trembling. And it is Syvus's turn.
Hello. Ill omen again.
Okay.
It's all I can do from this distance.
Just
get fucked.
All right.
That's what I got.
Adhara.
I have a question that I know I don't want to answer, that I don't actually want to ask. Because I don't want to make this boss more effective. So they're just going to try and pull her down. Yeah, they're going to try and bite to pull so that they can be flanking. Nineteen to hit?
Yep.
Sweet. So that is... 9 points of damage. And... Uh, 27 on the pull.
And Hara pulls Aela down. And she kind of hits the ground and is just, she's struggling to keep her feet. She like is on her hands and knees, still trembling, but she is on the ground.
Well, now I feel bad. Unfortunately, I am going to follow that up with an attempted tail smacker.
Mm-hmm.
And now I would have flanking, right?
Yep.
Cool. Twenty-one.
That hits.
Okay. For 5 points of magical bludgeoning.
Okay. She is still up. Well. Conscious, alive,
yeah.
Undead, unalive, whatever. Renza.
Cool. That doesn't give me. I'm gonna do something a little interesting. No, it takes too long to be useful in the combat. But it might give me something interesting. I'm actually gonna use Detect Magic.
Okay.
Because whatever's going on with that fluctuating and that issue, it seems odd. And I wanna see if I can figure out what's going on.
There is a magical aura kind of emanating from I need to hold on one second.
I've got the vibe check that there there is the presence of magical aura for this first round, but I don't get more than that right now.
Yeah, so there's magical aura kind of in her direction.
Yeah.
There is also magical aura coming from this body here in the corner, on the floor.
Huh, okay.
And there's a smaller magical aura among the offerings.
Okay. Cool. Okay. Interesting.
Asha.
That's me for now.
Sorry, wait. Joe, is there anything else you wanted to do?
No, that's me for now.
All right, Asha.
I feel like it's gonna be in poor taste to do the funny thing now. She's kind of pathetic. Make a fortitude save.
At disadvantage.
I have morals.
That is going to be a 21.
Aspect does hit, so you don't get all the damage, but you do get some of the damage, because you're never gonna guess.
Screaming?
I'm screaming at you. What's half of 11? That is an odd number. What? I don't know how words work.
It doesn't matter.
Oh!
Did I kill her?
You scream, and she, like, winces away from it, but in the next second, she sort of, the movement takes her over and she collapses onto her side and she is no longer moving.
Oh no. Oh,
I feel awful.
Congratulations.
Oh no. My lack of morals has turned around to lead to soul-crushing guilt.
She is half sort of laid in the edges of the pool, the water kind of soaking up into the shroud and her hair sort of floating gently.
Huh.
Renza, as you look more, the aura around her is actually less around her and more around just the shroud that she is wearing.
That's... some kind of an enchantment on the shroud. I think. There's some other things that I'm picking up. Can I... I need to wait one more round to be able to... Although you technically gave me the location of the auras, but it's fine. But once enough time has passed that I can I start trying to identify the schools of magic on... You said that this body, the shroud, and there was something else that was giving me an aura, right?
One of the things among the offerings by the sarcophagus.
Okay.
Both the shroud and the thing around the body seem to be...
I think we need to do a check for this.
Oh, go for it. Sorry.
I mean, you're giving it to me for free, but technically need to...
Make a check.
So that's the final one on the first one.
I assume that's one on her shroud?
Yeah, I think I'll do on the shroud first.
Okay.
27 on the second. Let's call it the corpse, because I want to make sure it's not going to try and jump me.
Mm-hmm.
Can Cypress still stay alert?
Specifically, the DC is,
Yep, I'm looking at it right now.
Yeah, okay. And then that is also 27 on the third, which is going to be the little... whatever's near the offerings.
Yeah. So you're gonna pass all of those. The one on her is very much abjuration.
Okay.
The one on the other body is a little abjuration, but it's mostly illusion.
Huh.
And the one over by the offering, which as you look closer, you notice is a little leather-bound book.
Yeah.
It gives off a lot of different magics, but the overarching of what you're getting is like is healing and restoration.
Yeah. Restoration ping from, based on the shape of it, it's a book over there, a little bit of abjuration and illusion, and abjuration on the shawl. And she's gonna dismiss the detect magic because I shine from hell. And then it's gonna actually go over to the remains and see if she and Adhara can figure out what happened. Well, specifically what was causing that seizing and trembling. Because that's not...
Make a... Make an Arcana or a heal check. Or a heal check. You may also look at Asha, yeah.
Can I just keep an eye out for things that might try and get us while we're investigating stuff? I'll just keep watch.
Yeah, make a perception.
Okay. Oh, for fuck's sake. I'm not using this dice today. That's a natural one from me.
Okay. Arcana. With the Arcana check, as far as you can tell, there is absolutely nothing magical that happened to her body at all.
Yeah.
And Asha, the book you pick up, congratulations.
Yo!
Oh, I can't use this. Yo. Somebody else could.
Sybus!
Oh, hell yeah.
Oh! Oh, okay. I see.
That's so fucked up.
Oh.
Are Oracle's divine casters?
Yes. Yeah.
Good for them.
Give Sybus a magical item.
Put this in the Sybus box, but chewing the lore.
It's free book.
Free book.
Free book.
Oh man.
Artifact.
This is so fucked up. She was just chronically ill.
Yeah!
And they made her into the first undead.
Man.
Oh no. I need to look over a previous document. Because PK, I think it gets worse.
What doc, which doc, with the words, which one?
And in order to keep the freshly dead in a state worth reviving.
I don't know what... Oh. Worth reviving?
No!
Had her in this state, had her preserved so that when someone who was skilled enough at divine magic came, she could revive her and try to heal her.
Man. Oh no.
Speaking oh, no. of, as Renza, as you are searching, you can also have access to the funerary shroud.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, I had a feeling that us just attacking her was a bad... God dang it. No. This poor girl.
Sorry, oh, no. lady. I Second feel question. So bad for screaming her to death.
Second question for you, Paco. Does Adhara have any way, does Adhara know any way to keep her from rising again? She's dead. She deserves that peace.
Adhara kind of looks at her and then looks at you and she's not undead in ways that I recognize.
Okay.
Would you like the less depressing magical item?
Yes!
Yeah!
Oh. Huh.
The body in the corner is this- is a corpse that seems untouched. It seems younger than some of the other things, but also more rotted through. And the robe that you pull off is this sort of long gray robe with this soft, like, fur-lined interior.
Body rotten. Robe on body.
Robe on body. Yeah, that's true.
Sorry, nobody answered me, and I thought maybe I'd forgotten how to talk and didn't actually say that out loud.
Yeah, no, sorry. I am typing a message to Parker because...
I'm just reading the document. I'm sorry.
I thought maybe I failed to say it out loud, and then I didn't want to continue in case I failed to say it out loud.
Yeah.
Okay.
Are you worried about the body possibly, carrying mummy rot?
No, not in the slightest. I'm...
Okay.
Body rotten. Robe on body. But... one of them. Next to pool.
Yeah. Huh.
Not... See, have we... find bodies, we find bodies of people who have time and time again taken their own stuff and regenerate...
Yeah.
You know?
So you think the Grey Watcher didn't wake, it didn't regenerate?
I think, yes. Because body rotten, robe on body, nice robe, would have put it back on.
Yeah.
Is right next to the pool, so not like he died somewhere else and was like, ah, fuck, I can't go back and get my body. Homie, the pool is right there. This man stayed dead.
This man stayed dead, or he walked
out of here entirely naked, and one of those seems weirder than the other.
Can we take a look at, like, the symbols on the shroud and stuff and see if there's anything that we recognize?
Make an arcana or a religion check?
Oh,
or maybe even a history check.
Let me see.
Oh, I would love to make a history check, bestie.
Listen, Parker, I know there is some cognitive dissonance with we are going to steal this woman's funeral shroud, but I also want to make her comfortable when she inevitably has to fucking wake up again.
Doesn't matter which one I roll, I have the same modifier for all of them. +2. No, that's a 9 for me. That would have probably been Arcana, because I think that might have been the thing that Cypress knew more. He doesn't know what these are, probably.
31 history, okay. Drop numbers in chat, please. Yep.
Listen, I know we're in the apocalypse, but you still have to show compassion where you can.
Mm-hmm. I will get to your role in a second, Joe.
Yeah. Yeah, no, that's okay.
Okay. Cypress, no fucking idea.
Yeah.
God bless. History.
There's symbols on there.
So, Asha, you can't, like, read the symbols directly or even necessarily, like, understand their arcane purpose from a history check. But what I will give you is that the way that they are embroidered into this shroud and the patterning and what you're kind of starting to recognize from, like, recognizing the writing system of the Nudoran kingdom and comparing it to the Akavian system, This is fairly standard for the time in terms of the way they protected against necromancy, like undesired necromancy and such things. The fact that it's embroidered into her shroud instead of, like, either painted on the body or on the sarcophagus or inscribed in paper, like on that was placed inside, like in her hands or something, is a little unique.
Mm.
And the embroidery here with the fabric, the way it is, it is very high quality. It's not... None of the fabric is rotted. None of the... There's no rips or tears. Maybe that's to do with its magical nature, but also it's beautifully soft. Excellently embroidered. There was money and craftsmanship put into this, even if it's unusual. You technically don't have to take it. You can leave it with her.
Hey, Here's a philosophical question. Can the dead feel comfort?
If you want to.
Rinta immediately looks at Adhara, because Adhara might be the only one who knows the answer to that question.
Yes.
One vote for yes.
I'm getting one vote for yes.
Adhara kind of tilts their head and says, I am far more familiar with what is left over of a person after their death than their body. For that, yes, they can. Not all of them do, but they can.
There's a reaction from Cypress a little bit at that. Some sort of emotion. Who knows?
Adhara kind of looks down at the body and goes, I don't know how much the state of one's body relates to that. Most things rot.
Her mother must have loved her very, very much. Here's another philosophical question. Do you think any living person other than us is ever going to make it back into this place?
There's always people after us.
Do you think anybody's going to see her and understand?
Did we?
Probably not.
No, I don't think so. We didn't until after, as it was, so.
Cypress nods.
Asha is taking the shroud.
Yeah.
Renza, as to your question, Joe, I think some of it hinges on the fact that you don't know how she's going to wake up.
Yeah.
You don't know if she's going to crawl out of the pool or simply have her body reanimate.
If her body is going to reanimate, is there any way that I can make it less bad? Like, I can't make it painless. That's not... Renza can do a lot of things, but she can't do shit for a genetic degenerative condition. And this was definitely a degenerative condition.
You could arrange her nicely.
Yeah, arrange her nicely and maybe...
pull her out of the water.
Yeah. I think that's what Renza's gonna pull her out of the water and lay her as comfortably as possible. Yeah.
I think Cypress will take one of his blankets and tuck her in with it, basically. Kind of like a... It's a very... warm blanket. It's one of his travel blankets that he's purchased. So it's a nice quality, thick travel blanket. Hopefully. This is probably the most, nice thing Cypress has done. But he doesn't say anything when he does it.
Among the Watcher's body as well, I will say.
I see.
Renza, you find a small key gripped in its hand.
Yeah. Huh. Now, where does this go?
Take a look around the room, see if there's anything a key would go into.
Make a perception check.
Okay. Please, for the love of God, let me roll something above a 10 today. God damn it! Let's see here. My perception's alright, but, that's a 15. I rolled in a 4 on the dice. Oh my god.
So you can't find anything in this room, but you know there were places unexplored in the rest of the catacombs.
Yeah. Should just use the dice room. Maybe it belongs out there.
Yeah. Maybe it does. She also, I think she will sort of collect the Grey Watcher's robe, although not for herself. Maybe for herself. She's decent stealth. But. Because unlike the shroud, there is no guilt about.
Yeah.
Going to that shit.
I think Aleth having that would be pog.
Yeah. I think Aleth having that would be.
Well, when Astris, if Astris gets here, gift for Astris. Hey Astris, you missed a bunch of emotionally conflicting information. Have a magic item.
Have a robe. It's gray. I think it'll fit your style. No doubt about.
But I think before we go to find what this key connects to, Renza just kind of murmurs to the body, I hope your rest is as painless as possible. And I'm sorry. And we want to back up so we can go find where this key goes, don't we? Because I don't think there's anywhere else in this room.
Nope.
Okay. Well, that looks like a corridor. At least a little bit of one.
Mm-hmm. Is that the corridor you wish to travel down?
If the party agrees.
Yes, that sounds just fine.
Okay.
I didn't look to see what corridor, but I figured it was fine.
So here's the thing. It's edging on 10 o'clock. I have to get up early for work tomorrow. I don't want to end session until Astris gets here, but Astris is also a half hour late.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like we could all probably do with a little bit of friend debrief after that one, TM.
Wait, would you... Here, I'm gonna send you emoji in the Pets Please channel. Hold on, he's very cute today.
He is... Look at his eyes!
Oh my goodness!
He was just chilling there, sitting there with them when I went to go get my goldfish. Cutest little man.
Baby cat, where you be? Where you be, baby cat? Hello,
little man.
It's fresh.
Yeah, kind of glad that the combat ended, because good lord, my rolls tonight, what the fuck? I don't think I've had that bad of luck in a long time.
Oh, there she is.
Oh my god, she.
She?
Oh, Scoop.
scooping her.
Scooped, idiot.
Okay, I'm gonna change which camera goes though. So.
Forced to be emotional support cat.
The moment she started crying, I was like, oh no.
Elith is, sorry, not Elith. Aelid is going to be the most emotionally devastating boss we have. Okay?
At least for a while.
El.
I'm so sorry for doing that to you.
Man.
I'm doing philosophy in my brain, by which I mean Asha is doing philosophy in my brain. I'm not.
She is important, though. I can't tell the story I want to tell without Aelid.
That's okay. That's I like it. Make me sad.
Sing Jasper as...
She was also not supposed to fail her fort saves that hard.
Aww.
That did make it more tragic.
Mm-hmm.
That did paint a wildly different image. But the fact that the only damage she got to do was an agonized cry, and then everything was too much, I think adds some layers to something.
I feel
really bad for screaming her to death.
If it makes you feel better, she was gonna still try to kill you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, when you're...
Yeah, that's why I was going... That's why I had to rein in the, oh, is it something magical that's fucking with her? Because it's like, it's because we want it to be!
Also, should I stop recording or no?
Yes.
Okay. Just wanted to ask.